gradually shifting on the non-communicable diseases. Recognizing this fact, the government of India has now started an NCD program, which includes, you know, cardiac diseases, stroke, cancer, and the like. And most of these have a common thing in factor, that is, most of them are lifestyle diseases. So, these lifestyle conditions, which the shift in rural to urban population, to civilized society, people are becoming more sedentary, people are becoming more desk-oriented, work, table-oriented work rather than work with physical activity. Gradually, it leads on to many conditions, increases the risk factors. The stress of work induces hypertension, diabetes, then of course, if they add on smoking and alcoholism to that, the risk factors keeps on doubling. So these are the bane of the society of late. And among these things, with these risk factors, and of course hereditary factors also contribute a lot, cardiac problems are becoming more and more. Cardiac problems are now recognized in increasing frequency as the leading cause of death. I think now the deaths due to cardiac problems are much more than the deaths due to road accidents or cancer put together. So that being the case, it's time for us to, as physicians, as cardiologists, as people who take care of everybody's heart, it's imperative that we think of cardiac emergencies also. We have heard stories of, a lot of stories that young individuals dying suddenly. We have read in papers that a boy who was exercising in gym collapsed and died on the spot. We have seen young individuals following a swimming competition dying. You know, such deaths are quite commonly reported, even though they don't have any risk factors. But there are other factors which we may not have.
Cardiac related diseases are life threatening. I would say it is a sword that cuts everyone but may not be equally. Some or other, some kind of palpitation or changes in the ECG or some kind of anxiety that makes us to have this kind of disease. Once I was here in the institution some years ago, a man was discharged. There was a public telephone just outside my office. I was the assistant director at that time. And he was speaking in Kannada, speaking to his wife, which I could hear while I was on the veranda. Out of joy that I am discharged and I will come home soon. And with that only, with the handset, he collapsed there only. He was immediately taken to the casualty, but that time his life could not be saved. Some, just a year ago perhaps, a program was going on, like a roast program, and there was an entertainment also. A young girl, a student of a college, was dancing. And while dancing, she collapsed. And fortunately, some of our staff were there who were trained in CPR and they could attend very immediately and could save the life of that girl. But later, she survived for some time, maybe for a month, but could not save her life. But at that moment, it was life-saving. Measures were taken by those who knew. So a very apt subject has been chosen, cardiac emergency. We do not know when it will come. I remember some years ago when I was in Udupi side, one doctor, old young doctor, 52 years, every day he used to go for a walk, 1 hour walk, comes back sweating, sit, relax, read the daily Kannada newspaper, Udayavani, and at the same time his wife was bringing a cup of tea for him, and he used to enjoy that tea and then afterwards go for his maybe for bathing and for breakfast. And that day it so happened, he came from his walk, just sat and called his wife to bring the paper, and she brought the paper and she went inside and he started reading, and immediately she heard a noise and she rushed out from the kitchen. The man was on the floor, could not be saved. Vice Chancellor rightly mentioned, when we are ignorant, it is very difficult. We feel ashamed of ourselves. And therefore today, for the cardiac emergency, simulation is a very, very special opportunity. I think, not to mention, we are the first one in South India or in Karnataka especially to have the state-of-the-art simulation center after visiting D.Y. Patil in Mumbai, and then we also went for that. And today we can proudly say that we have nearly 30-35 trained staff and who are able to train others, and in different places they are going and giving the training.